somebody else said that they saw it over here.
I mean, there's, I don't know how.
I got an email from a Good Samaritan saying that there was a stray dog in their neighborhood.
Oh my God, I hate going to this area.
She's running around in a neighborhood that is more busy and there is traffic, and the neighbors are really concerned about having this stray pit bull running around.
That's like so scary.
Hearing that this dog is roaming freely in a busy neighborhood, I knew I needed backup.
Is Elise there?
Mm-hmm. What are those little meatballs?
Yeah.
Your leash, Heidi.
When we first pulled up and saw the area that the dog was in, we knew that we were gonna have our work cut out for us.
Oh, it's here, dude. It's open on the other side.
Everything was open. There was no way for us to really contain her.
I don't see her at all.
There's a lot of holes and, you know, the dog can go underneath houses.
She's over here, Heidi.
Hey. Oh. Hi, honey.
She's not in the worst shape that we've ever seen, but you can tell she's probably been running around on the concrete for some time. Her nails are pretty shaved back.
Come on, come with me. Come on, let's go over here. Let's go over here. Yeah, see? We're all good.
Some of the ways that we try to, you know, build trust with a scared dog is food. That's the number one thing. You know, a lot of times these stray dogs are hungry, and feeding them treats and food, it kind of makes them realize that you're there to help.
Oh, don't hit it. Don't hit the dog. God, that guy looked angry.
These dogs that have been living in the streets for a while, they are really smart, and it's kind of hard to trick them. It takes a split second for them to make a break.
I need more treats. Here, honey. Where are you going, Mama? Yeah, she's leaving now. She's going to her other space.
She went behind a house into an open lot.
Hey, buddy.
She's coming that way.
Hi. Come see. Here, I have cookie for you again. Here, you're okay.
Like,
maybe
something,
going
or no?
That in the hole?
Maybe we should try to block it off or no?
That's what I'm thinking. She's too free.
It's extremely important to be patient with rescues like this, because if we're rushing, it's gonna freak the dog out even more. You know, we have to hope that she stays in the vicinity. So I keep getting nervous that we're gonna spook her and she's just gonna take off and we're gonna lose her.
I'm gonna give her a chunk in the bowl. Hey, mama, look. I just didn't want her to run out.
I'm not gonna be able to loop her. It's just not happening. She's not getting close enough anymore.
Oh.
Okay.
Other side to your left. You see
her?
Behind the house. Yeah.
She came out. She's in the yard next door.
She said she's in the yard next door now.
Which is blocked.
It's blocked completely. She's leaving.
She was basically just bouncing around from open lot to underneath the house, back to the other street.
You over it, Mama?
We were just constantly moving.
Maybe we just wear her out.
We're never gonna catch her, though, unless we can get her in an area.
It's okay, Mother. Oh, it's okay. Relax.
It's, you know, getting pretty dark out here, so, you know, you start to get a little bit desperate and you do catch yourself kind of trying to rush a little bit because you want to get the dog off the street. So I think everybody's just trying to move as quickly as possible, and in some ways it's spooking her more.
Oh, she's back there. She is back there, and there is a gate.
The dog went into yet another yard, and there was, you know, a shed back there, a bow, and we're thinking like, okay, maybe a new area to try to contain the dog.
She's looking underneath. Ow. Wanna get in the boat with Heidi?
Oh. No, she's gonna go under. She's coming around to your left, behind the axle.
She's over on the side now.
Oh, I see her.
There, she's coming out the front.
Coming out the front. The dog was running around the boat and then underneath the boat.
I hear movement. Where is she?
She's behind the metal over here.
You're okay, my child. You're fine. It's okay.
Unfortunately, there were two other pit bulls living in the yard bordering the shed.
She's coming through.
Oh, God. No. Ryan.
She's kind of wedged back there.
Yeah, she's wedged back there.
She's stuck right there. Somehow she got herself like wedged in this tight little space next to the boat and behind this wooden pallet that was not very sturdy. You know, if she pushed through that pallet, she was gonna be in the neighbor's yard with the two other dogs. That was really scary for me because three pit bulls fighting is like, I can't think of anything worse that could possibly happen right now.
This dog is literally touching its body.
Yeah.
That's so up against this pallet. That dog's touching it.
Those two dogs were getting worked up by our presence. So the fact that they're like already really jacked up is really scary if she decides to push her way all the way through into the yard. We decided that we were gonna need the neighbor's help to contain his dogs.
All right, he's gonna bring them in.
All right.
Okay, that's how we're gonna get her.
Yep.
Thank you.
She's kind of wedged back there.
Yeah, she's wedged back there. We just didn't want there to be like a fight, you know?
Right next to that pallet.
Yeah, she's wedged behind this pallet right here. And she was trying to push into your yard.
Kind of makes it better for you. Got like a hole in my shed, she'll run in my shed.
Oh, really?
I'm gonna put something right there, I'm gonna just move it and she's just gonna run in.
Is it completely closed in?
Run in, yeah, sure.
Well, we want to try to get her looped from right here.
That's what I'm saying. Here. If I move the little board I have against the shade right there, she's gonna run at my shade.
Oh, I see what you're saying. She can't get in contact with your dog, right?
I mean, she's been in contact with my thing for like 2-3 months. This is like her boo boo.
Are you serious?
Yes,
I'm serious. I'm not the boo boo. I'm not the boo boo.
You know, she's sticking to that area for a reason, and now after seeing the two dogs behind the fence, that's probably one of the reasons why she's sticking in this area. We really appreciated the neighbor helping and coming out and grabbing his dogs.
Oh, ooh,
you see her? Look, see her body?
She.
Oh, yeah.
She's
okay,
right there.
On.
Look at her head's facing up.
Hold on.
Oh, here's her head. I got her.
Elise got her. She's leashed.
Elise was tiny and climbed up the fence and was able to kind of squeeze herself back there a little bit better and was able to loop her.
Good girl. All right, we're coming out. Come on.
Good.
Good girl, mama.
Good.
I can see that she's still very scared. So we just need to move really slowly with putting her in the crate and try to make her feel as comfortable as possible.
Good girl.
She was licking my hand.
I think she's gonna be
sweet.
The next step is just getting her settled into a more quiet area of the warehouse and just letting her get comfortable. We're not gonna push her. We really need to let her get comfortable and warm up to us and, you know, start building her trust before we can do anything else.